On this day, with more than its share of climate news, we turn first to the White House South Lawn and the signing of the first Arab-Israeli agreement in a quarter century as Israel normalized relations with Bahrain and the United Arab Emirates. In a moment, we'll get the views of top presidential adviser Jared Kushner. But first, foreign affairs correspondent Nick Schifrin lays out the stakes of the deal and today's moment.
Israel, Bahrain, and the United Arab Emirates have never fought a war, but they all hope today sparks peace.
After decades of division and conflict, we mark the dawn of a new Middle East.
This peace will eventually expand to include other Arab states, and ultimately, it can end the Arab-Israeli conflict once and for all.
We are already witnessing a change in the heart of the Middle East, a change that will send hope around the world.
The normalization agreements pledge to settle disputes without force, establish embassies, create direct flights, and expand investment, tourism, and trade. The countries share economic interests that extend from Tel Aviv to the Emirati business capital, Dubai.
The great economic benefits of our partnership will be felt throughout our region.
The countries also share fears of political Islam and Iran. Shia Iran threatens Israel and Sunni countries with the region's largest missile inventory and proxies that have expanded their influence. Analysts also say today is about shared doubts about the U.S. commitment. Israel is now seen as the most reliable regional partner. The UAE is hoping to buy American weapons, including the F-35, and by goodwill in Washington among those who criticize the country for helping lead the war in Yemen that's killed tens of thousands. Before today, the U.S. had hosted the first two Arab-Israeli agreements with Jordan and Egypt that swapped land for peace. But left unsolved today, Israel's core conflict with the Palestinians. The Emirates say normalization halted Israeli annexation of settlements in the West Bank. But during the ceremony, militants in Gaza fired missiles into Israeli cities. And this morning, Palestinians in the occupied West Bank protested normalization before peace. Palestinians and many regional analysts warn regional peace is impossible without Israeli-Palestinian peace.
The real conflict is a Palestinian-Israeli conflict, and that's what needs to be solved. This is the only way to peace and security and stability in this region.
The U.S. hopes today creates irreversible momentum that isolates the Palestinians. In the meantime, today makes overt what had once been covert, a partial Israeli Gulf realignment of the Middle East. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Nick Schifrin.